friends, my name is Sarika Tulsiani. Today in this video, we are going to see the concept of races and circular tracks, and we'll be solving a few questions based on that. So let's start with races. These are linear races. So to understand the concept, let's look at a sum directly so that we can understand it well. Now what is the question? In a race of 1000 meters, A beats B by 50 meters or 5 seconds. So it's a 1000 meter race, it's a linear track. A beats B by 50 meters or 5 seconds. Now the question is, find B's speed and the time taken by A to complete the race. So A ko time kitna lagega to complete the race. Now understand one thing. See, let's say this is my linear track. They're saying in a race of 1000 meters, so the length of the track is 1000 meters. Okay? A beats B by 50 meters. What does this mean? When they finish the race, okay? When A has reached the final point, this is my final point. So A is at 1000, B, A beats B by 50 meters. So the B kidhar tha? B was at 950, correct? Because A beats B by 50 meters. So the gap between them was 50. They are asking you, find B's speed. We also know A beats B by 5 seconds. So what does that mean? When A reached the final destination, B took 5 seconds more to reach the final destination. Because A beats B by 5 seconds. So let's say if A took X seconds to finish the race, B took X plus 5 seconds to finish the race. Okay? So if I ask you what is B's speed, how will you get it? B's speed. What is speed? We know speed is distance upon time. Can I say B is going to cover this distance of 50 meters in a time period of 5 seconds? Because whatever time A took, B took 5 seconds extra. And B had to cover a distance of 50 meters. Correct? So the distance to be covered is 50 meters. And the time taken is 5 seconds. Okay? Because it took 5 seconds more. So the speed of B is 10 meters per second. So B takes 10 meters per second to finish the race. But they are also asking you one more question. What is the time taken by A to complete the race? A took how much time? Now we know B's speed. B's speed is what? 10 meters per second. So if B covers 10 meters in 1 second, B has covered a total of 950 meters. So 950 meters will take how much time? If 10 meters take 1 second, 950 meters will take 95 seconds. Correct? So B took 95 seconds to reach this point. I know one thing. Jab B idhar pahuncha, at the same time, A reached the final destination. Correct? When B was at 950, A was at 1000. Correct? B took how much time? 95 seconds. So, A will also take 95 seconds to finish the race. Because after 95 seconds, A had reached the destination, B was 50 meters away. Now, one thing you need to understand is, generally students get confused here. See, they started from the same point. Initially, A was here, B was also here. So what do students assume? Let's say at the final point, A was 50 meters ahead of B. A or B mein 50 meters ka difference tha. It does not mean that at every point, the distance was 50 meters. See, think logically. They started at the same point. Eventually, A ka speed was more. So A moved ahead quickly and finally when A reached the destination, then the gap was 50 meters. But when they were running the race, this gap kept on increasing. So the gap was not 50 meters at every point. They started from the same point. So initially the gap was 0. Then A started moving ahead. So the gap increased. Let's say it became 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meters, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay, so finally, when A reached the final point, then the gap was 50. Okay, so that does not mean that at any point in the race, the gap is going to be 50. No. This is the biggest mistake most of the students do. So what do they do is, let's say somewhere in between, let's say A is here, B is here, they'll assume the gap to be 50. It will never be 50. it will be less than 50. Finally, it became 50. So before it was less than 50. So this is one of the most important concepts of linear time. Now let's look at the next question. What does it say? In a 1500 meter race, T beats M by 150 meters and M beats R by 75 meters. By what distance does T beat R? Okay? Now, let's see. You have a race or track of 1500 meters. Now they are saying T beats M by 150 meters. So when T was at the final point, when T reached 1500, T beats M by 150 meters. So where was M? M was 150 meters behind. So M 150 meters piche tha. So if this is 1500, where was M? M was at 1350 meters. Okay? Jab wo final point pe pahunch gaya, this was 150 meters behind. Now they are also saying M beats R by 75 meters. Now don't do this mistake. What do students do? If M is this, 75 meters, they write 75 here. And there, here somewhere, they will place R. This is not the case. We understood this in the previous question right now. What did we understand? The gap between them is not 75. When M reaches the destination, then the gap becomes 75. So before, during the track, it was not 75. While they were running, it was less than 75. It eventually became 75. So that means when M was at the destination, that means when M was at 1500 meters, then it beats R by 75 meters. So R was 75 meters behind. So agar ye 1500 hai, so this was 75 meters behind R. So where is R? R is at 1425 meters. Now the question is, by what distance does T beat R? Okay? T beats R by how much distance? Now what do we do? Find out the common person first. Who is the common person? M is the common person. Okay? Now using M, we are going to find the relation between T and R. Okay? How? When M was at 1350, T was at 1500. Correct? When M was at 1350, T was at 1500. When M was at 1500, R was at 1425. Okay? R was at 1425. Now the question is, when M is at 1500, R is at 1425. So when M is at 1350, where is R? Okay, where is R? So we'll cross multiply, we'll find out this value. So this will be question mark into 1500. Is 1425 into 1350. Okay? So if I calculate the value, I will have question mark is 1425 into 1350 upon 1500. Now, so this value becomes 1282.5. So what is this 1282.5? It means when M was at 1350, my R was at 1282.5 and that time T was at 1500. The question is, by what distance does T beat R? When T is at 1500, R is at 1282.5. So by what distance does T beat R? It will be the difference of these two. So that is 1500 minus 1282.5. So ye difference kitna aega? The difference will be 0.5. And this will be 712. So that means T beats R by the difference of 217.5 meters. That is your answer. Now, let's look at the next question. In a 500 meter race, the ratio of speeds of X and Y is 3:5. The ratio of speeds is given. So that means when X will cover 3 meters, Y will cover 5 meters. So if X covers 30, Y covers 50. The ratio is 3:5. X has a head start of 200 meters. So X is already ahead. X already aage hai 200 meters. Who wins the race? Okay? Who is the winner? Now understand, it is a 500 meter track. Okay? X and Y are going to have a race. But X already has head start of 200 meters. So x is already ahead by 200 meters and this is y. So what is the remaining distance? The remaining distance is 300 meters. Correct? The question is, who wins this? Now one very important statement is, the ratio between them is 3:5. Correct? The ratio is 3:5. Now you don't need to use any formula, any concept for this. Just think logically. X has to cover how much of the remaining distance? X has to cover 300 meters. Correct? Y has to cover how much distance? Y has to cover the entire 500 meters. Okay? Then, abhi dekho, one important thing is the ratio of speed is 3:5. So, X ka speed upon Y ka speed is 3/5. So, what does that mean? When X will cover 300 meters, in the same time, Y will cover 500 meters. It's very obvious because the ratio of their speeds is 3:5. जब x 3 करता है y 5 करता है जब x 30 करता है y will do 50 when x will do 300 y will do 500 at the same time and as per the problem x has to cover 300 only and in the time period that x covers 300 my y will cover the entire 500 so that means x and y will reach the final point at the same time. The question is, who wins the race? We don't have a winner as both of them will reach the destination at the same time. So this can be solved without any mathematical equation. Now let's look at one final question. What does it say? In a race, Renu gives Bharti a head start of 200 meters and still beats her by 100 meters. So Renu gave Bharti a head start of 200 meters. मतलब रेनू भारती वॉज अहेड बाय 200 मीटर्स स्टिल रेनू वन द रेस बाय डिफीटिंग भारती बाय 100 मीटर्स सो व्हेन रेनू वाज एट द फिनिश लाइन भारती वॉज 100 मीटर्स बिहाइंड. ठीक है, इफ रेनू स्पीड इज 1/3/7 टाइम्स भारती स्पीड व्हाट इज द लेंथ ऑफ द रेस. द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द लेंथ ऑफ द ट्रैक एट विच दे आर रनिंग. नाउ अंडरस्टैंड वन थिंग, सी, did they start at the same point? No, because Renu gives Bharti a head start of 200 meters. So that means Bharti is 200 meters ahead of Renu, correct? But still beats her by 100 meters. Okay? So that means when Renu reached the finish line, Bharti was 100 meters behind. Okay? Bharti was 100 meters behind. They're asking you what is the length of the track. Let's say the length of the track is D. Okay, the total distance is D. They're asking you what is the value of D. They've given you one important condition. Renu's speed is 1/3/7 times Bharti's speed. So, if I talk about the ratio of speeds, let's say Bharti's speed, Renu's speed is 1/3/7 times. So, if Bharti's speed is X, Renu's speed is 1/3/7 times of X. If I ask you what is the ratio, this will become 10/7, 7 × 7 + 3, 10/7 of x, and this is x. My xx will get cancelled. If I multiply by 7 on both sides, this will become 10:7. So this is the ratio of their speed. That means when Renu covers 10 meters, Bharti will cover 7 meters. Okay? So if this covers 20, this one will cover 40. The ratio is 10:7. Now the question is, what is the distance? You have to understand one thing. You have to figure out what is constant here. Is there anything which is constant? Okay? Now, can I say the time at which Renu covers the entire distance D? Jitne time mein Renu covers the entire distance D, Bharti covers how much distance? Dekho, Bharti was already 200 meters ahead. तो उसने ये 200 मीटर्स कवर नहीं किया. ऑल्सो भारती वॉज 100 मीटर्स बिहाइंड व्हेन रेनु कंप्लीटेड द रेस. सो भारती डिड नॉट कवर दिस 100 मीटर्स ऑल्सो. सो कैन आई से द टाइम एट विच रेनु कवर्ड द एंटायर डिस्टेंस डी, भारती कवर्ड डी -300 मीटर्स बिकॉज इट डिड नॉट कवर दिस 200 and this 100 meters. Okay, so can I say that time is constant? Renu's time is the same as Bharti's time. Okay, time is what? Time is distance upon speed. So Renu is covering how much distance? The entire distance d. Okay, what is the speed of Renu? The speed of Renu is 10. You can take it as 10x and 7x also, or you can take it as 10 also. It does not matter. Okay. In the same time, Bharti is covering how much distance? She is covering d minus 300. She did not cover 200. She did not cover 100. What is the speed of Bharti? Bharti's speed is 7. Okay. So this becomes 7. So this is the time taken by Renu is the same as time taken by Bharti. Correct. So if I cross multiply, I will get 7d is 10d minus 300 into 10, which is 3000. 3000 will go on the other side. That will be 10d minus 7d, which is 3d. So if I ask you, what is the value of d? It is 3000 upon 3, which is 1000 meters. So the length of the race at which the both of them were running was 1000 meters. So this is how you solve. So we have seen sums on linear tracks or races. In the next video, we'll be seeing sums on circular tracks and the concept of circular tracks. I hope this clears your concept of races. If there is anything you would like me to make a video on, please do mention in the comment section. And if there is anything else you would like to share or ask, you can mention your doubts in the comments. And please give this video a like, thumbs up. And please subscribe if you like the video. Thank you so much.